You may be considering some other roles within nursing, and that's kind of what this series is all about. So this video is the top three reasons why you should consider becoming a magnet program director, and the top three challenges that are associated with that. If you're new here, I'm Dr. Lisa Chappell. I'm an associate professor of nursing, a doctor of nursing practice, and studying to have my board certification as a health and wellness nurse coach. I make videos for nurses, students, nurse educators, and nurse leaders and caregivers on how to become more empowered and resilient. Please like this video if it's helpful to you. Subscribe below if that content sounds interesting to you, and hit that bell for notifications as I do release videos weekly. And I wanted to thank my whole 24 subscribers for coming along this journey with me. I am still very early and new in my YouTube journey, and I'm learning a lot, and I so much appreciate your support. And I would also appreciate whoever is stumbling upon this video to go ahead and come join us and subscribe. It's really fun building this community of professionals associated with nursing and how we can support you further. All right, without further ado, what am I talking about when I say a magnet program director? Well, if you've been around nursing for a while, you probably know what magnet recognition program is, or at least you've probably heard of magnet or magnet hospitals. Most states at this point have magnet hospitals, and I need to pull this up because last I checked, I think it was New Mexico that was the only state that didn't have magnet, but it changes because sometimes hospitals become magnet and then they kind of drop off that list and maybe lose their magnet status. It's not something that's guaranteed forever when you get it. So let me just check, and then I'll explain what magnet is in a second as well, just in case you haven't heard of it before. So I think that all 50 states except for New Mexico still. So I think that almost all 50 states have magnet hospitals. There are approximately just under 9% of hospitals have that magnet recognition status, which still isn't huge. But magnet is also an international program. What is magnet, first of all? The magnet recognition program is awarded by the American Nurses Credentialing Center, which is under the American Nurses Association, as a credential or a designation specifically for nursing excellence. Magnet began in the 1980s when there was a landmark research study that examined the characteristics of hospitals with high retention rates of nurses. They attracted and retained these fabulous nurses and did some research on what are the characteristics that hospitals have that can attract and retain fabulous nurses. And from that came the original 14 forces of magnetism. That evolved into what is now the magnet model and the 5 core standards of magnet. I happen to have maybe more knowledge than I would care to have, because at one point in time, I was a magnet program director for a specialty hospital. So I'm gonna give you the top three reasons why you should consider becoming a magnet program director and the top three challenges associated with that. So let's get started. The first reason why you should consider becoming a magnet program director is because it's a pretty rare, cool job. There's only 562 magnet credentialed facilities in the world at this point in time. So you would be one of only 562 that have your same job. The ANCC, or American Nurses Credentialing Center, requires that facilities that are going after magnet status have a designated magnet program director. And that's what the ANCC calls it. Hospital organizations or facilities that are trying to achieve magnet designation may not necessarily call that role a magnet program director. They may call it a magnet program coordinator or a magnet project or even an innovations coordinator, or there's all kinds of titles. And the the MPD, as I'll refer to it, the Magnet Program Director, may be their only job, or that job could be where they wear many hats. They might be a director of some other department and also have Magnet kind of added on to their plate. And so there's lots of different ways that facilities will allocate the Magnet Program Director. In general, this person should be a leader within the organization. They do have to be a nurse, as far as I know. Let me know in the comments below if you know of an MPD who is not a nurse. I think that most of them are, if not all of them. This person is charged with sustaining a culture of excellence, as it's called, within the Magnet Recognition Program, and also ensuring that nurses at the bedside, the frontline nurses who are carrying out the work of nursing, have a large voice within that organization. And the Magnet model utilizes the Don Obedience model of structure, process, outcomes. So the meaning of this is there has to be dedicated positions in the structure of the organization and in the hierarchy that allows nursing to have a voice within the organization. One of these is that there needs to be a chief nursing officer. Also, there needs to be positions throughout the organization that give nursing a voice within that facility. So there might be unit educators, there may be nurse researchers, there's many different ways that facilities will organize their structure, but they have to demonstrate that nursing has a voice. And so back to my first reason that this is a really kind of a cool job to have, that you could be a part of that, creating and sustaining this culture of excellence within this organization that you work for and making sure that nurses have a voice within that organization. It sounds cool, okay? It's rare, and it's certainly a conversation starter. People outside of nursing, when you tell them I'm a Magnet Program Director, my clock is dinging. It's certainly a topic of conversation if somebody asks you, what is your role? And you could say, I'm a Magnet Program Director. Nobody knows what that is outside of nursing, so it's a great opportunity to do some education with them about giving nursing a voice within an organization and really elevating nurses. It's a very cool role to promote nurses. So that's why the first reason I would say, go for it. The second reason why you should consider becoming a Magnet Program Director is because you'll have these amazing opportunities to look at your organization as a system rather than having a more narrow perspective from a bedside nurse perspective or even a nurse leader's perspective. Because one of the roles of a Magnet designated organization is to show that nursing has a voice within the entire organization. And in order to do that, you'll need to really understand the organization as a whole, which is a really cool opportunity to have a different vantage point on the organization that you work for. The number three reason I would recommend going after this role as Magnet Program Director is as a launching point into a new phase of your career. If you can become involved with Magnet Recognition early on and create or sustain a culture of excellence within the nursing department as well as within that organization and getting people excited about Magnet designation, and then writing this document, which is massive. It's a huge, huge challenge and a huge role to be a Magnet Program Director because you're responsible for documenting that culture of excellence and also documenting those outcomes of these high quality nurses. And really, Magnet has shifted to be more about the outcomes. And so if you want to be involved in quality management and looking at the documented quantifiable difference that nursing makes, for example, with nurse sensitive indicators, those hospital associated infections that the research shows when you have nurses who are highly engaged, highly educated, and who are invested in patient care, you have better staffing rates, you have higher satisfaction satisfied nurses, that that makes a difference in hospital-acquired infections, in CLABSI, CAUTI, catheter-associated urinary tract infections, central line-associated bloodstream infections, hospital-acquired pneumonia, ventilator-associated pneumonia, pressure ulcers, that nurses make a difference. That's why they're called nurse sensitive indicators. And so you'll be tracking those. As a magnet program director, you may be involved in the national database for nursing quality indicators, or if you're in California, I think it's called CalNOC, the California Nurse Outcome, you'll be involved in tracking and documenting nurse sensitive indicators to demonstrate that nursing makes a difference within your organization. And there is a requirement by magnet to keep those outcomes above a certain standard when comparing your organization or specifically each unit to similar units. It's required to benchmark these quality indicators against other like units. And so if you like quality and you like data and you like writing and you like writing reports, I would highly recommend you consider becoming a magnet program director. So the top three challenges with being an MPD. The first one I would say is that you burn out very quickly. This is a role that, unless you've been really involved with magnet for a while and have designed some templates for yourself over time that you can continue reapplying, then it's an extremely challenging role every 5 years to reapply to make sure that all of the paperwork is in order. And those magnet documents are anywhere, they're thousands of pages long. They've reduced the amount of documentation that you send so that hospitals aren't sending everything they have, and then these appraisers are only having to read a smaller amount of documentation. So it has decreased, but it's still thousands of pages. And it's not just writing about here's what we have at our hospital, it is demonstrating. So really showing the evidence that you have all of the policies and procedures in place with the structure, that you have the positions in place, that you have a process within that organization. So if you notice gaps and holes, then you're going to need to advocate with the leadership team in order to make improvements so that you can meet these documentation standards. This can burn you out very quickly. Most MPDs I know only make it through maybe 1 to 2 rounds of magnet recognition. I've known one MPD who went through 4 recognition rounds, and I think she's still going. So, you know, there's some that are really suited to this position, but I think it's the rare person that can do it multiple times. However, it's still a launching point to really propel you, challenge you, and help you move into the next phase of your career. It's an amazing resume builder, for sure. So the third challenge I would say with being a magnet program director is sometimes not having a lot of authority. You have an incredible amount of responsibility, but not a lot of authority. So the responsibility that's on your shoulders is this magnet recognition that the hospital is investing thousands of dollars into, if not millions of dollars, that they're investing in nursing staff, and then also to obtain this designation. But there isn't always a lot of authority depending on how this position is allocated at your organization. You might not be at a director level, and you might really have to be working with the chief nursing officer and have to have a really good working relationship with them in order to get any momentum and changes that you need to make without a huge amount of authority. And so when you're trying to get documentation from all the various leaders, you might not have a lot of rank and pull in order to get that. And it can be a very frustrating experience. I will also say that the ANCC is very much invested in the chief nursing officer. And so you won't get a lot of accolades, I think, as an MPD. So sometimes it's that assist position that doesn't get a lot of recognition. So you're doing all this right, you're very much invested in the process, and you put in an incredible amount of work and heart and soul And then, you know, your name might not even be mentioned when you receive magnet designation. So it's kind of all about that chief nursing officer and not as much about the MPD. And that can be a frustrating experience, but it is still worth it. I would say if you are up for a challenge and you feel like you like writing and you like to really be engaged and invested in making sure that nurses have a voice within their organization and pumping up and propelling up nurses, then this is a great position to get going on that. And as I said, you can only go up from here. So once you have that magnet designation under your belt, you are one of very few people in the world who have done that, who have achieved that, and know that process start to finish. And again, really fantastic resume builder and something that you will use the rest of your nursing career. So if that's a position that is sought after in your organization and you are at a bedside nursing level, there is a lot of, I think, knowledge building that goes into that. I didn't feel very prepared to do it as a bedside nurse with a master's degree, so I did decide to go and get my DNP, which actually really aligned perfectly with writing the magnet documents. And I feel like I was able to kind of merge those two and kill two birds with one stone, so to speak, because the things I was doing for magnet, I could count toward my DNP and leadership work and vice versa. So it really worked out nicely, but it was also extremely challenging. And so if you're up for a challenge, go for it. And I look forward to hearing about your journey. Please comment in the comments below. Have you been involved with magnet in some way? If not the MPD, then maybe you are a unit champion, or that you're involved in some other way. So I'd love to hear about it. And what are your perspectives on the role of a magnet program director, or even on magnet designation in general? I'd love to hear about it. I hope this video has been helpful to you. Please give it a like if it has been. And also be sure to subscribe below and hit that bell for notifications, as I do release new videos every Wednesday. Have an amazing day, week, month, year. Thank you so much for being here.